or afternoon, evening, good night, regardless of what time of day it is. Hopefully all is well and safe. It's me, Mikey Pipes. I thought for a second this was the uncensored channel where I could say Mikey Blank Pipes along with Air Force None. Today is Tuesday? Tuesday, July 19th, 2022. It is 8:30 in the morning. We just finished up two estimates. I like to do my estimates in the morning, you know, 7, 7:30, and 8. You know, before we actually get to the real service calls, the bread and butter. But we know you got to do those estimates, get those proposals out there to get the bigger jobs. So we sold a 3.5-ton Bryant. And we just sold a 3-zone Fujitsu ductless system. Not bad. Not too shabby. On our way to a service call right now in Lynbrook. Right now we're heading north on Peninsula. We are in Woodmere, heading into Hewlett, and then we're going to a job in Lynbrook. I've been to this house for the past several years, once a year. I believe it's like a Weather King or Thermozone, some, maybe a Root or a Ream, but I'm just going to prepare you because it's not ideal work conditions.
Oh boy.
Yep.
So that's that. So stick around and make sure you smash that thumbs up button. Smash the thumbs up button like you want to make mashed potatoes.
Smash it or I'll smash your knees. We'll break your kneecaps. I'll send Air Force None to you. To break your kneecaps.
We're here. What's wrong with their shit today?
AC not working. Can't you tell by all the windows open?
I could tell, but...
You ready?
I guess.
A hazmat suit?
Oh, it's not that bad,
is it? Let's go!
Should I put on my coveralls real quick?
Yeah. Tyvek suit.
Oh, boy.
You ready?
Yep.
Hopefully we don't have to go into the attic. Let's pray for 24 volts and blower action.
I'm not showing you my own face. It's my crying face.
Okay, yep. Beware of the dog. Do not knock. No peddlers. No peddlers. Well, how are they going to ride a bicycle if they can't pedal?
Damn graffitis.
T-shirts available. Details in the description box down below. Okay.
I remember you from last time. You were here last year.
Yes.
How are you?
How are you? All good.
Come
thank
in,
you. Thank you. All right. Is the air conditioning not working?
Not working. And same thing as last year.
What happened?
It just, the air stops getting cold.
Oh.
And you replaced something. And I remember you saying, if I have this in the truck, this is an easy fix. And if I don't, and you had it.
I had good. Let's look at the filter real quick.
Oh, okay.
It's right here in the hallway.
And I forgot how to take it down, so you're gonna have to show me.
Okay. The filter looks dirty. We need to change this filter. So let me just.
How do you do that?
Magic.
Clips,
yeah, little clips.
Do you want a spool?
Not yet.
Okay.
Chris, grab it. Okay, let's bring that outside.
I'll take it out in the back and give it
a. Yeah. We'll give that a good washing.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. I'm just going to turn the thermostat on.
Sure.
Is that the one here in the hallway?
Yes.
Okay. Let's see. Whew. It's churning. Blower. Okay. You see the dust moving? We have a good blower. All right, let's go outside. See what's going on. Let's take a peek over here at this Weather King. No compressor. maintenance on this bad boy. All right, so we have this 3-ton Weather King R22, manufacturer date of December 2005. Got the power off. Let's see what's going on in this bad boy. Oh, it's a 5/16. Okay. Let's see what we got here. We didn't have any compressor running.
How's the capacitor?
Capacitor looks okay, but you know what? If you ain't testing, you're guessing. So let's take this bad boy out and take a peek.
Yep.
Wow.
Yeah, she's dead. Let me make sure I got a good contact.
Here, go straight down on him. Yeah. 19. Let's do fan. With this one, the fan.
5.
5. Wow. The Titan Pro. Need the Titan Pro HD.
What was that, 45 amp?
And this is one of the reasons, well, I actually can feel it. Like it's, they could feel like it moving around in there. One of the reasons why now my company installs the HDs. No more of these Chinesium garbage.
Oh? I'm gonna throw them where you're standing.
Oh, in the leaves? Okay. I took the cover off just to clean out all this mulch. I know she had asked for another year or two out of the system, so as long as there's not a refrigerant leak or the compressor goes kaput, you know, we could give this old lady some new life. So right now we're taking all the mulch out of the bottom. She's wearing a fur coat. All right. So we're gonna take off the panels.
She's not powered, right?
She's not powered?
She's not powered, right?
What do you mean?
Just making sure there's no power going.
Well,
on, right?
the condenser fan motor is gone, yeah. And you're deep inside of her.
I just want to make sure.
Deep inside. Chris, you have a joke to tell today?
I do have a joke.
You want to tell a joke?
Tell you a joke. You know what an e-girl is?
An e-girl?
Yeah.
It's like an e-bike?
Like no, it's
electronic,
like, you know,
girl?
Like you find a girl online, she's an e-girl, right?
Yeah.
Do you know what an i-ladies is?
I-ladies?
Yeah. I-ladies nuts on your forehead. Oh!
Oh! Oh, what it is to be young again. All right, get all the crap out of there. Get all the cocky out of there, Chris.
Scooping it.
And for the replacement, the Titan HD, made in America, ladies and gentlemen. You got all the cocky out of there?
Cocky.
All right, now we're gonna take the panels off. Mm-hmm. And then we're gonna hose her down. We're gonna acid wash this bad boy.
All right. Like the patient can be safe?
We have to replace a part.
Okay.
Also, the coil's filthy.
Okay.
So we're gonna take the unit apart and clean it.
Oh, great. Okay.
All right, yeah. I'll calculate this total for you, but you know, it's a little more labor involved, you know,
sure,
to take the panels apart, but you had asked, you know, for a year or two more, so.
Yes, please.
As long as the freon levels are good, and,
okay,
and as long as the compressor doesn't die, you know, she'll last, you know, for years to come.
Do what you need to do.
You got it.
Thank you.
I'm getting there. Hold on. Forest.
Let me see.
What?
The thing.
This thing?
So that way you don't have to come into the forest. I'll record this for you.
Oh, I got it.
All right.
I'm using the DJI handheld gyroscope. Come on, baby. Pay attention. There you go.
Not only does she have a fur coat, but she's also got about a mountain
of dirt surrounding her. Wow. Well, she wanted us to buy her a year or two. So, oh. Sorry. Look at this. Look at this fur coat, ladies and gentlemen. Look at that. Crazy. Insane.
You ready to see the rest of the bag?
Yep. So, Chris, Air Force None, is using the Venom Pack, the Viper, by Refrigeration Technologies. All right. You can get that at United Refrigeration and other local HVAC distributors. I'm using the new Calgon coil gun. We use the rest of the Viper. All right. And we're going to take care of this horrible, horrible coil. Let's move the CLC knee pad away. Let's get that out of the way. All right, let's move the replacement cap out of the way as well. And let's clean this coil. All right, you ready, Air Force None? All right. We're cleaning from the inside out. As you can see, the foaming action is working quite well on the inside of the coil. And we're forcing water through the coil to the outside. Now that the inside has the venom working on the outside of the coil, I'm gonna get that backside. Get a light coating on there. All right, let's just see. Focus a little more back. All right, you wanna get the coil gun as close to the, look at that. Close to that as possible. Look at that, still coming out of this machine. Look at that. We might need to do some more. Wow, that is incredible. Okay, while the Venom Pack and the chemical is working on this condensing coil, what works for me is I like to rinse out the coil gun with fresh water, fill it up, and run it through a cycle of fresh water just to clean everything out. Clean the canister, clean the whole assembly, right? Get all that clean. If you're using the new Bright, right, if you don't rinse that out very well, you go next time you go to use this, it's trash, it's garbage. And there goes your $100 investment out the window. So we rinse this off very, very religiously, get it nice and clean. It also gives us time for the chemicals to work on the condensing coil. All right, let's get that filled with water. Just gonna clean that out. And when that's done, we'll give it a few more minutes and then start rinsing this coil. All right. Allowed the Refrigeration Technologies Venom Pack to work into this coil. All right, now let's take a look at how filthy this is. You ready? Let's go. Look at that. Absolutely perfect. Holy cow. This water is black. Incredible. Look at that. Insane. Absolutely insane. Look at all that dirt and grime and dust. Just incredible. Alright, we're bringing this, we're giving birth to some more life. Wow, absolutely incredible. Make sure you keep your feet dry. Wow, night and day difference. Look at this. This is what happens when you don't do proper service and maintenance. Alright. How efficient was this machine? It wasn't. Not at all. Nowhere near efficient. But now, look how much better that is. Look at that. All right, we have three other sides to work on. Put it back together. All right. did our best with the condensing coil. Now Air Force None, keeping his boots dry. He's putting her back together. Not easy, especially when you have poor drainage, as you can see here. But at least we'll have a much better functioning system and reduce the operating expenses to run it, because the amount of electricity this thing is using, that filthy coil, just unacceptable. So I'm quite confident we're gonna have much better results, especially with the newer and improved Titan, the HD dual capacitor. We're gonna give her a lot more time left on the system. All right, the unit is reassembled. A few more screws left. And I have the Titan HD dual capacitor in place. It's all wired up. She's good to go. All we need to do now, all the screws are secured, flip that breaker, and we're good to go. I'm gonna stand back so in case Air Force None blows himself up. And there you have it, look at that. She's blowing bubbles. She was blowing bubbles. Hear that compressor hum in the background. With a nice clean coil now. Job well done. The unit itself is from 2005.
Wow, that's old.
Yeah, so. But like I said before, as long as you don't have a freon leak, and as long as the compressor doesn't die, things like this can be fixed, can be repaired. You know, when, you know, the coil is, you know, was pretty filthy. You know, it was one of the worst that we've come across. Oh, so that's the reason why we took all the panels off and did all that. But as long as, you know, parts can be replaced. Listen, can I replace, you know, a couple thousand dollars worth of more parts in here? Absolutely.
Yeah.
I could,
yeah.
But is it necessary? No.
Not yet.
Not exactly.
Yeah.
You know, hopefully, you know, I would suggest, listen, it's an older system. I don't know what temperature you keep the house at during the
74.
Summer. 74. Okay, so it's a little bit of a warmer than average temperature. So, again, I don't know what your electric bill is like, but the warmer you keep it, if you have good insulation in the attic, you know, those are all contributing factors to a lower electric bill.
Right.
You know, if the attic insulation is horrible and the thing's running nonstop, you know, you're going to have a high electric bill. But one of the things to consider when you get a new system, when the time comes, the electric bill for air conditioning will be cut in half.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I don't know what you're paying in the summertime versus the winter.
I don't even know, because it's automatically taken from
the
house.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah.
I think if it was high, I would know.
Maybe not. But, you know, it's probably $300 a month in the summertime.
I think it's actually less than
that. Okay, that's a good price then. Good price. You know, but she's up and running now.
Thank you.
Just going to do a few more tests, and should be good to go. And that's the reason why, ladies and gentlemen, we don't buy anymore the Titan Pros. Strictly American-made Titan HD. No Chinesium for my clients. None of that bullshit right there. None of that. What?
No.
How's that water? You know what I think you want right now? I know it's a little early. It's 9:35. How about some White Castle?
That's a little early.
White Castle? All right, guys, thanks so much for tuning in. Until next time, be well, God bless, stay safe.